Hi there, my name is Matt. I work in the education department for Cranbourne Music, and today I'll be running through a simple demo of a Yamaha PA system, very similar to the ones that we have sold a lot through to high schools and primary schools throughout Victoria. Today we'll be basically demoing how to set up the PA fresh out of the box. I'll go through all the cabling you need, and also we'll be demoing a simple microphone setup, also a guitar setup. We've got a Shure SM58 microphone, we've got a mic stand, two passive PA speakers, and this model is the Yamaha EMX312SC, and that's our PA head. Just take your average jug lead included, plug it into the back of the unit. We've got two speak-on cables here, which is what you need with this setup. These are sold separately, but I'll show you how they run. So, speakers here, and you actually twist it in to lock it. Same goes with the speakers. Just plug it in and a simple twist to lock. You'd repeat the same process for the second speaker. Okay, next you want to plug your microphone in. We'll start with the first channel, and it's just the input above the one. So you take an XLR cable, plug it in there, and this end will go into the back of the microphone itself. It's at this point, when you've got your microphone plugged in and both speakers hooked up, that we want to turn the unit on, and we do that simply by hitting the power button on the lower right side. It's a good idea when you've first switched the unit on to have all the master levels at a zero volume. This one here is your overall master volume. You don't need to get confused about all the knobs. Basically, you can just look at it in purely terms of strips. So input one is this strip here, volume is right here, and then you've got EQs for that channel here. So your monitor level is your level that controls the monitor out, which you can run an alternative speaker as a fallback for. You've got it plugged in to input one. You've got both volume knobs at the very lower limit, and basically what you want to do is just give it a little bit of volume on the level and a little bit on your master. And now your microphone will be on. So to set up your effects, which is simple things like reverbs and delays, you go over to your effects program knob, and you can see your list of effects here. So for example, if I wanted to put a whole reverb on my voice, I just switch it to one. And the effects level on channel one dictates how much reverb I have in my microphone. Just a quick note about feedback. Basically, what you want to do is run your microphone in a straight line with your speakers, not necessarily in front of your speakers, because that's what creates the feedback loop. Same goes with acoustic guitars. For this demo, I'll be sitting on this speaker playing it, but majority of the time, you want it, your guitar to be a fair way away from your speaker. So you've got an acoustic electric guitar, for example, which is basically an acoustic with a pickup in it. And what we want to do is add this to our mix. So we'd go into the second channel, which is this one, and we'd plug it into our instrument input. A good idea also is to make sure that your level is on zero. Plug your instrument cable into the guitar itself. And then we can wind up the volume on channel two. And then you get your guitar straight through the PA. So the last thing we're going to do in this quick demo is basically plug an iPhone or an iPod into the system so we can play music through it. You'll need this cable. And we have an option here on this channel to simply plug these red and white cables in to align input. So the red goes on the red, the white onto the white. And then this attachment would plug into an iPhone, just as you would headphones. So in this case, we'd probably have the effects off and all the EQs flat, and we'd just simply dial in the volume with this level button. Okay, so I'll quickly go through the overall EQ part of the PA on the overall mix. So if you'd like it to be a little bit brighter, a little bit more trebly, you would do something like that. Or if you want to add a little bit more bass or take some bass out, you would go to the lower ends like this. That's less and that's more. But for most purposes, you're going to run the EQ fairly flat. That's how we set up a simple PA with a microphone, a guitar, and an option to run music. Thanks a lot for watching today, and we'll see you next time. Okay. So thanks a lot for watching. That's been a demo of how we set up a... I'll do it again. So thanks very much for watching. You get a fly on your camera.
No, I saw that.
So thanks very much for watching today. That's how we set up.